through a lot over the past year, and one of my main issues that I've talked about is eating disorders and self-harm and anti-bullying. I've battled with depression, and one of the main things that I've overcome with those issues is building myself on the inside, definitely trying to love myself before loving others. When you love yourself, you can take care of yourself, and, you know, it's just, it's a great lesson that I learned. It's not okay to starve yourself, and it's not okay to self-harm. It's not okay to bully other people. When you're struggling with a problem, sometimes it's hard to realize that you need to get help, but I think that hopefully they can come out and realize that they can get help for their problems and hopefully live a longer and happier life. Hey, I'm Demi Lovato, and I'm Positively Positive.
She's currently got a top-selling book, and she's got an award-winning album out, and did I mention she's only 21? Amazing. Will you please raise the roof for Demi Lovato? Let me hear you. Demi, they're a lively lot. You always get this reaction.
My fans are always amazing, so...
I tell you what, Demi, we've had some crowds outside waiting for people who are on the show, but never like this.
Never.
Anyway, it's lovely to meet you. Are you enjoying London?
I am. I love it here.
Yeah, what about our weather, though?
It's cozy. Everyone's like, oh, sorry, the sun's not shining, but I live in California. I see enough of that.
Yeah, so you always see sunshine. Yeah, but we need sunshine.
And we need rain.
Well, look at the colour of me, Demi. I'm not white, I'm blue-grey.
Listen, I don't look like I get a lot of sun either, so it's all good.
So, Palinette, you're over for two special gigs.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
I am. I'm playing at GAY.
Oh, I know the owner.
And I'm also playing at Coco.
All right. Well, I can tell you from first-hand experience, you're going to have a ball in both of those venues.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I'm excited. I can't wait to see, like, GAY is so iconic, and I haven't been there, so I'm excited to see the energy there and how and what makes it so iconic.
Oh, it's the crowd, actually. They're just so full of energy. So they go out for a good time, put it that way.
Okay.
Yeah, they really do. They really know how to enjoy themselves. You're going to have a ball, young lady.
I'm
an
excited.
Absolute ball. When's the new single out?
The new single out is on June 9th.
Yeah, I should have asked you lot that, shouldn't I? Because you've been out. Oh, look at them.
What's the single? Neon Lights. You know what's funny is I release Neon Lights over here and Really Don't Care in the United States, so it's two different singles, so that's why they're confused. Yeah, I'm just as confused as you guys. I just make the music and then I put it out there.
Demi, they wouldn't care if you sang the Yellow Pages. Honestly, look, they're so excited. Anyway, we're going to have a look now at Neon Lights, the music video. Let's have a look, please. You also sang the song from Frozen, didn't you?
Yes,
did you realise that was going to be such a huge hit, that movie?
Honestly, I mean, I knew whenever you do something for Disney Animation, you kind of expect that it's going to have amazing success. So it was an obvious yes. I love the song. I love the meaning. And when I went to the Disney offices, I saw some of the scenes and edges. I fell in love with it.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, nobody can predict a movie being like the best-selling animated.
It's the biggest animation we've ever made. Yeah.
Yeah.
Beats, it beat Snow White hands down, Sleeping Beauty, everything. It's amazing.
I'm just honored to be a part of the soundtrack. Like I said, like I am not a character in the movie, but my song was played in the credits, and I just was so excited.
I bet you were. You recorded the original of Skyscraper, didn't you?
Yes.
What did you think of our Sam Bailey's version?
I think she did really great. Yeah, it was beautiful.
She's got a great voice, doesn't she?
Yeah,
she really
does.
Has. Now look, let me talk about that. Your career started at age 6.
Yes.
And you co-starred with Barney the Dinosaur.
I did, but I actually, that was when I was, I made it when I was 7 and then I started working at 8 and I did that for 2 seasons.
Yeah, and then Camp Rock, that was your big break. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, it was fun. I got to incorporate acting and music, so that was like the most ideal first project for me. Yeah.
Do you come from a musical family?
I do. My mom used to be a country singer.
She's not Dolly Parton, is she?
No, she's not. She's not. She used to open up for Reba McEntire and George Strait.
Oh, lovely. Love Reba
McEntire. Hank Williams
Jr.
Yeah. So I grew up around music.
Yeah. Even in the womb, she sang, so you absorbed it.
Apparently.
Yeah.
I got it from somewhere. I'd like to think it was not from inside my mother's womb.
Well, you know what they say, put the Hoover on when you're pregnant.
I don't know what they say
for the baby.
That.
Yeah, they do over here. Yeah.
Okay.
I was brought up with the Hoover. Every time I hear a Hoover now, I'm on the floor.
That's a vacuum, right?
That's the vacuum cleaner.
See, I just imagine like a vacuum and a pregnancy, like that, just those two things don't go together to me.
Well, they tell you over here, this is very soothing for the baby. I wouldn't find it soothing at all.
Got it. It comes out naturally though, right?
Exactly.
Not with the Hoover. Okay.
No, you don't get the Hoover. No.
See, I didn't know where you're going with that.
No.
Okay.
It's the sound of the Hoover. I don't say when your waters break, you say, quick, get the vacuum, get the baby out.
I'm sure that's what they say. I mean, back in the States, it'd be get the Swiffer, but...
Look, you've done so well. I mean, you, as well as selling all these albums, you've written this lovely book as well, Staying Strong, 365 Days a Year.
Yeah.
And do you know something? I read this over the weekend, and it's so mature.
Thank you.
I mean, it really is. You know, when I was 21, I'm not much better now, but when I was your age, I was a complete airhead. I could not have sat down and compiled all these beautiful quotes from all over the place and all your thoughts as well.
Yeah, I've lived a lot of life experience and...
I gathered that by reading the book,
Yeah. And a lot of people know my story and some people who don't. I've been through a lot and I wanted to use my story as an example to be an inspiration to other people that are going through whatever it is that they're going through. I've seen, I've had fans that that have told me it's helped their parents, you know, and this book is meant for anybody, whether you're 12 years old or you're 62.
Yeah, no, it's a great book. Did it take you long to write? Did you enjoy compiling it all together?
I did. You know, what was funny is I had a deadline for the book and I had spent the whole year working that, like, in a week or so, I had to write this book.
I know what
I'd already
like.
And I had already taken all the quotes that I liked, and then I literally have, like, stacks of paper that are just filled with edits and pen marking and coffee stains from red-eye flights from L.A. to New York.
Are you a leave-it-to-the-last-minute girl?
I am.
Yeah,
totally am.
Yeah, I'm a bit like that. I don't mean a girl, but, you know, I leave it to the last minute as well. No, I do. Do you work better under stress?
Sometimes. I bet I work faster.
Yeah. Well, you've got to, haven't you? Especially you've got a deadline with publishers.
Yeah.
Now, look, Paul McCartney is from the same place as me, hence the accents. Did you run him over?
No, see, it's a funny story. What happened was, so for those of you who don't know, Paul McCartney is a singer. He was in this band called, they're very popular where I'm from, so I didn't know if it's the same over here. The Beatles. And anyways, I was driving my car and I was on my way to music rehearsals and there was no parking spot. So there was one empty parking spot and this guy was facing the other way with two other guys and they were on a laptop looking at something. And I was like, how rude. Like, don't they know that I'm coming? I need a parking space.
Move.
Move.
Yeah.
And so I almost laid on the horn, and I'm glad I didn't, because turned around and was like, oh, sorry. And I was like, oh. And I, yes, like, I was like, oh, my God, that's Paul McCartney. Never mind, you can have the parking space. I'll park in the street. Like, don't worry about it.
I just wondered if that's why I was in hospital, because Demi had backed up over it.
No. This was a while ago, and I made one tweet about it, and then it was on CNN, so...
That's it.
It was a little exaggerated.
Yeah, it's only a little nudge, wasn't it?
It's a cool story.
Of course it is. Demi, I think you're a remarkable young lady.
Thank you.
I really do. And thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, come on. Demi Lovato.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Yeah,
honestly.
Nice to meet you.
And you as well. Nice to meet you. Up next, we have the following.